हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंस फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 90। व्हाट्सएप हैज हॉप्ड फॉर द लीगल अप्रोच अगेंस्ट द इंडियन गवर्नमेंट सीकिंग टू ब्लॉक रेगुलेशंस कमिंग इनटू फोर्स ऑन वेडनेसडे। इट हैज चैलेंज्ड रूल्स रिक्वायरिंग द आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ द फर्स्ट ओरिजिनेटर ऑफ द मैसेज। द लॉसूट हैज आस्क्ड द दिल्ली हाईकोर्ट टू डिक्लेयर दैट वन ऑफ द न्यू रूल्स इज अ वायलेशन ऑफ प्राइवेसी राइट्स इन इंडियाज कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन सिंस इट रिक्वायर्स सोशल मीडिया कंपनीज टू आइडेंटिफाई द फर्स्ट ओरिजिनेटर ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन व्हेन अथॉरिटीज डिमांड इट। WhatsApp said that tracing chats is equivalent to keeping fingerprints of every single message and that would break the end-to-end encryption. This would fundamentally undermine people's right to privacy, it has said. And WhatsApp further said that it will continue to engage with the government on practical solutions. WhatsApp is rolling out an update that brings supports to adjust playback speed in voice messages. The new experience is coming to Android and iPhone users as well as on WhatsApp web and desktop clients. It lets you increase playback speed in voice messages by as much as 2 times using the native controls. In addition to the update, WhatsApp has brought a new sticker pack called Off It Off to Android and iPhone devices. The sticker pack includes 28 animated stickers to choose from. Xiaomi said on Wednesday a US court has removed the company's designation as a communist Chinese military company and lifted all restriction on US persons buying or holding its stock. The US District Court for the District of Columbia issued a final order vacating the US Department of Defense designation of the company as a CCMC. The smartphone maker said in a filing to the Hong Kong Browse, it said that order was made in Tuesday. The company reiterates that is an open, transparent, publicly traded, independently operated and managed corporation, Xiaomi chairman Liu Jun said in a statement. Battlegrounds Mobile India launch date is tipped to be the third week of June. A recent report claimed the game will be released on June 18th. Battlegrounds Mobile India pre-registration for Android is already open. The Government of India warns users against sharing the COVID vaccine certification on social media. The vaccine certificate contains personal details like name, age, gender, among others. The Government of India issues a provisional certificate after the first and second dose of the vaccine. ICICI Bank now giving users choice to sync UPI ID with Pocket's e-wallet instead of savings account. The Pocket wallet with UPI support will essentially streamline transactions undertaken daily from their savings account. It would also allow users to declutter savings account statement of multiple entries. Facebook and Instagram will now let users hide like accounts from their posts. The company announced earlier today the latest development comes month after testing with selected users worldwide. In a press note, Facebook said that the new option would give users more choice over their experience on the two platforms. Previously, Instagram had told its testers that the new option would aim to pursue users to focus on the content that they share and not how many likes they are getting. Users can now hide likes on an individual post or collectively for all, including others. Microsoft has announced that the company is opening up its video conferencing platform Microsoft Teams to more developers to let them create tools for its growing user base. Announced at the Microsoft Build 2021 event, the new changes will essentially aim to help 145 million users using Teams every day. First up is a collaborative tool for developers that would let them build applications that can plug into Teams meeting canvas. Microsoft says that it also wants to simplify this experience for developers to allow their application for teams to work across platforms such as Windows, macOS, Web, iOS, Android and Linux. The Teams Together mode that uses AI to segment place sneakers to co-workers in a virtual place is also being opened up. It would allow developers to create more Together mode backgrounds and scenes to make meetings more engaging and personalized. You don't hear much about them, but Royal unveiled the first foldable phone in the world that is now working on another technology, stretchable displays. These are used on micro-LED tech built on stretchy elastic circuit. Why would you even want a stretchable display? For one, those can be stretched into various shapes, creating spherical and some dome-shaped displays. It's look like curved screens. You can see it on TVs, monitors and phones, except with a curve on two axes. The USB Implementers Forum has announced version 2.1 of its USB-C specification, which more than doubles the power delivery capacity of the standard. The current USB-C standard that you find on thin and light notebooks these days is limited to 100 watt, so it is not suitable for power-hungry gaming laptops with dedicated graphics cards. However, the new standard can deliver up to 240 watts, so it may make an appearance on gaming laptops soon. HMD Global shipped over 2 million Nokia smartphones in the January to March period, that is up on year-on-year was 1.7 million in quarter 1 2020, but down from the previous quarter when the number of shipments reached 2.8 million. What went wrong and what went right? Nokia smartphones lost ground in India. They were down 38.5% from quarter 4 last year and down 17% from quarter 1 last year. Nokias are doing well in Africa and other parts of Europe, which helped boost shipments compared to October-December quarter. Product director at Lenovo, the company is facing an issue with supply as newer wireless network cards are out of stock. Just earlier this week, the known PC brand released a number of new products, including notebooks, tablets, and even peripheral accessories. Now the company's executive said that the shortage of networking-related components may lead to some models being downgraded to Wi-Fi 5 standards. Amazon has sealed an $8.45 billion deal to buy MGM, the company that owns the iconic Hollywood studio known for releasing movies in the James. TSMC has reportedly begun mass production of Apple's A15 chipset, which will power the iPhone 13 users. Production is expected to allow for a September release of Apple's next line of iPhones, despite chip shortages and COVID-19 spikes in area with Apple-related factories. The reports that demand for the A15 will surpass that of the A14. A15 will use the same 5-nanometer node as the A14, but Apple is rumored to use 4-nanometer chips in 2022. It sure took some time, but Redmi finally brought the Redmi Note 10 Pro to its home market. The big difference with the international variant comes with the chipset department, where we find MediaTek Dimensity 1100 processor. The Chinese version also offers faster charging and a better protected display with a slightly altered back design and a camera island. There is a change in the display as well. The new Chinese Note 10 Pro gets a 6.67 inch LCD panel, which again refreshes at 120Hz. This display features a Gorilla Glass Victus protection in place of the Gorilla Glass 5 on the international variant. The stereo speakers are tuned by JBL. The Dimensity 1100 is paired with 6GB or 8GB of RAM and 128 or 256GB of storage. The camera setup features a 64MP main shooter, backed by an 8MP ultra-wide snapper and a 2MP of depth helper. The battery comes with a 5000mAh battery but doubles the charging speed of 67W with an included power brick in the box. You get MIUI 12.5 with Android 11 on the software front. Color option includes black, white and blue. Realme will be announcing the Realme X7 Max 5G and the new Realme Smart TVs on May 31 in India. Ahead of the launch, a moderator at Realme community has shared the unboxing image. The community moderator claimed that she will be revealing more details of the smartphone on a daily basis before the official announcement. OnePlus will soon launch the U1S series of smart LED TVs in India. The upcoming TVs will be offered in 50-inch, 55-inch and 65-inch display sizes. The brand is also launching a TV camera for video calls. An indication of the degree of acceptance in the use of driverless vehicle in Germany is the new legislation presently passed in the Bundestag. Germany's lower house of parliament that would allow driverless vehicles to ply public roads across the country from next year 2022. Last month, Samsung had listed a smart wireless keyboard dubbed the Samsung Smart Keyboard Trio 500 on its website. At the time, there was speculation that it would be unveiled alongside the Galaxy Book series. That did not happen, but the tech giant has now launched the Smart Keyboard Trio 500 in South Korea. Taiwanese PC maker Asus today announced the world's first convertible gaming laptop in India. The laptop called the Asus ROG Flow X13 will be accompanied by the Zipress Duo, Zipress G15 and the Asus Zipress G14 gaming laptops. The ROG Flow X13 is a highlight though, sporting a detachable Nvidia RTX 3080 GPU with integrated adapters and multiple ports. While detachable GPUs are not particularly new, Asus technologies have been critically acclaimed for plugging some of the gaps in involved with using Thunderbolt ports for adding desktop-grade external graphics to PCs. It is also essential for the convertible feature of the ROG Flow X13. However, eGPU is not landing in India yet. The launch time and price will be released closer to its launch. ARM version 8 has been around the years. It is the first time 64-bit version of the ARM architecture. Now it's time to move on to ARM version 9. No, it's not jumping to 128-bit, but it does bring the end of 32-bit designs. ARM is planning to take Cortex-A cores of 64-bit only by 2023, and it is working with its partner to ensure that the software ecosystem is ready to wave goodbye to 32-bit applications, a process that ARM hopes will be completed by end of this year. ARM unveiled new CPU and GPU designs that will be featured in future chipsets, as well as a new support hardware to tie them all together in varying configurations that will be used in everything from laptops through phones to smart TVs and other multimedia appliances. There are some exciting high-end designs, but it is an entry-level stuff that may prove to be a game-changer. Truecaller, one of the most trusted and accurate caller ID and telephone search engine platform, and it has around 195 million monthly active users in India. Today, the company has announced its partnership with MapMyIndia and FactChecker to improve the COVID healthcare directory feature. As per the company, the feature was launched for all Android users in April 2021. The new collaboration will help the app to provide easy access to a larger set of updated information. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.